I'm Danielle. This is my husband and bagel chef, Lewis. And together, we own Bear's Cup in Bolton Landing, New York. As bagel shop owners, customers are constantly asking us how they can store and freeze their bagels and then bring them back to life again once they've been frozen.
Step one for freezing your bagel is slicing your bagel.
You don't want to take your bagel out of the freezer and then try and cut a frozen bagel. So once you have that bagel that's perfectly sliced, you are going to want to saran wrap both halves pretty tightly.
If you don't want to use saran wrap, you can use parchment paper or wax bags. You could even use a paper bag. What's ultimately important is that we have a sealable freezer bag on the outside of everything. And as you saw Danielle was doing, she's pushing the air out to avoid freezer burn and make sure that we keep the moisture inside the bagel.
Once you finish that, your bagel's ready for the freezer. So let's fast forward about a month. You've got frozen bagels in the freezer and you want to bring them back to life. How are you going to do that?
Good news is we've already sliced our bagel. So all we need to do is pull it from the freezer. Pro tip, hydrate the bagel, run it under your faucet, give it a spritz with a little spray bottle if you have, and then put it right into the toaster oven.
And what you're going to get from there is a bagel that tastes pretty damn fresh. Happy bageling!
Hey Rach, this is Beth from BYOB Bagels. I love everything about bagels. And I thought, wow, I could take one of my cinnamon raisin bagels, drench it in a French toast recipe, and then put my mother's apple crisp on top of that. And now my mother passed away 5 years ago, so this is really special to me. And she would always give me these little recipe cards. So here we go. Beth's French toast bagel with my mother's apple crisp on top of it. We are going to do 3 eggs. I'm going to add 3/4 cup of milk, 1/3 cup of raw sugar, vanilla, cinnamon to taste. Put them open side down first, and then we flip them. So it's about 1 minute on each side. It's gonna soak in all that yumminess. Now we're going to do the apple crisp recipe. We add 1/4 cup of flour. This is in with the butter and the sugar. And now we're going to add in 1/4 cup of uncooked oatmeal. And this is 1/2 cup of finely chopped walnuts. And now I'm going to put in the chopped apples. And then we just really wanna toss it all together. Now if you're doing this with your kids, they're gonna love getting their hands dirty. We should be in for about 18 minutes at 350. We cooled these off on wire racks. Really, really good. I think she'd be proud.